Muhammad Ali, formerly Cassius Clay, is one of history's great heavyweight champions. He reigned supreme from 1964 until 1967. Then, still undefeated, he was stripped of his title by the World Boxing Association because of his refusal to enter the United States Armed Forces. Ali claimed he could not be true to his belief in his religion if he accepted the call to arms. He is a believer in the teachings of Muslim Elijah Muhammad, a leading advocate of black separatism.
The states here in America have now been increased up to 50 states, and America refuses to offer one of these states to the so-called American Negroes who have worked 310 long years, 16 hours a day, without a payday, which enabled America to be 50 of the richest states on the planet. We believe that our contributions to this land and the suffering forced upon us by white America justifies our demand for a complete separation in a state or a territory of our own. We want equal education, but in separate schools, up to 16 for boys and 18 for girls, on the conditions that the girls be sent to girls' colleges and universities. We want black people educated, taught, and trained by their own black teachers. Under such schooling system, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad teaches us that the so-called Negro will make a better people in the future. Any white woman in this audience today, any white man in this audience today, in their right minds, don't want little black boys and little black, white black girls coming around your home, schools, and churches looking to marry your sons and daughters and in return introducing your grandchildren as little half-brown, kinky-haired Negro children. No intelligent black woman in this audience want little white boys and little white girls coming to marry their sons and daughters and in return introducing your grandchildren as little half-white, green-eyed, blonde-haired Negroes. Any intelligent people love their history. Chinese love their beautiful culture and are not seeking to lose their identity. Puerto Ricans love their beautiful culture. Mexicans love their beautiful culture. Hawaiians love their beautiful culture. And the white man loves his because I see wagon trains on television every day with stagecoaches. We are not seeking to lose our identity in blood mixing and our beautiful black African history. We don't hate you. We don't hate those of you who are white. We just want to stay black. We love my color. I just love myself.